right now. So it's but reading's good for me. It's very, very important to read.
What's like the last self-help book or something, nonfiction?
I read what was the last self-help book I read?
Or just nonfiction, biography, or whatever.
A book called Problems at Work.
Problems at Work.
Yeah, Problems of Work.
Problems of Work, yeah. Okay.
I've read that book about 4 or 5 times.
Okay, I gotta check it out. I haven't read
and
it.
And sometimes what I do is, rather than reading a lot of different people, what I'll do is I'll read the same thing.
Yeah.
To make sure I got it, sometimes the number of times over is better for me. Like I start getting real understanding as opposed to just surface.
I'm not just saying this, but that's a good thing to do for me with the 10X rule.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you're going to capture some stuff maybe you didn't see the first time through, yeah. But it also gets you in the zone.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
It's a great book for that. And Tony, yeah. I like Tony Robbins too. He has some books like Awaken the Giant Within,
yeah, yeah.
And that's good to go back to.
You know, the thing for me about reading a book a second time or third time is that the predictability of it. I know the first time you read a chapter 6 of the 10X rule, you don't know what's in it. Second time you read it, you're like, okay, I know where he's going now.
Mm-hmm.
And I think people don't, one of the reasons the education system, I think, fails is because all those books are only read once.
Yeah.
You're never going to go back and do a chapter a second time. So how are you going to ever get good at it? I had a ball player in here yesterday. Who was here yesterday, Johnny?
Matt Joyce.
Yeah, Matt Joyce is in here. He's 140 home runs, all-star, Atlanta Braves.
Yeah.
I said, how many swings do you take a year? He's like, we play 200 games, plus practice another 100 days of practice, and he's doing 50 to 100 swings a day. Times
300
yeah. Times 20 years he's been doing.
Wow.
Tens of thousands of swings.
Yeah.
So you start getting muscle memory. People are reading. They're reading like one book a year.
Yeah.
You know, there's a guy out there right now that says he doesn't read. He's a successful guy, and he's like, I don't read books. I'm like, okay. Bill does. Billy Boy does.
He should start, right? I think if someone's successful not reading, then go see what you can do with reading.
Dude, like, how can it hurt you?
It's kind of fun, too. And,
yeah.
I mean, you can do audiobooks if you don't really like to read.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
And I really enjoy podcasts, too.
Yeah, yeah.
We're doing a podcast.
We're doing one right now.
Somebody is going to hopefully
somebody gets something out of this.
Listen to this and, yeah, get something out of it.
So, I strongly suggest that if you can ever get around somebody that will show you, somebody financially successful, not successful on Instagram.
Right.
But that is, see, I talk about the money thing a lot, you know, because like, you know, to make money is one thing. To make money and keep it, that's another thing. To make it, keep it, and then multiply it. You know, that's completely another thing. And almost nobody that does that opens their books to people.